Prabhupada, 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 Srila Prabhupada, Jaya Prabhupada, 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 Srila Prabhupada.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama.
Yes, I'm Bhakti Vikas Swami at Iskcon Dwaraka, headquarters of the Hare Krishna movement in Dwaraka, and I'll be happy to go around. I've published some information about ancient Dwaraka in a book of mine. This is how Dwaraka was 5,000 years ago. Let's go and have a look and see what it's like now.
Dwaraka today is a relatively small town with about 30,000 permanent residents, although there's always a floating population of pilgrims. These streets weren't made for big modern vehicles, which anyway aren't allowed in the area close to the main temple. That also, of course, helps to preserve the sanctity of the temple. You can see the air conditioners on the walls on the left and the temple spire in the center. That's a contrast typical of modern India. Cows, auto rickshaws and tractors. This is an Indian style traffic jam. Here I meet a priest as we go toward the Dwarkadhish temple. Dwarkadhish means Lord of Dwaraka. This temple was built 2,500 years ago at a cost of 12,000 gold coins. During religious festivals and the school holidays, Dwaraka is packed chock-a-block with visitors. But we've come in an off-peak season, which gives us a chance to look around and see the day-to-day life. Arati or ceremony of worship is going on. According to temple rules, we cannot film the main deity. We must approach with great respect and bow down and then stand to present ourselves before the deity and offer prayers to him. I'm heading for another part of the temple compound where students of the local Gurukul, a religious school, are chanting scriptural verses. Some of my fellow monks are already there. Every morning the boys chant here. Such recitation has reverberated throughout Dwaraka and throughout India since time immemorial. This is a shrine of Madhav Rai, another form of Krishna.
It's an important tradition in holy places that visitors should offer some dakshina, which doesn't mean donation, it means an offering. An offering to the resident brahmanas, those who are engaged in cultivation of Vedic spiritual knowledge. So we've just seen the students chanting very nicely Vishnu Sahasranam and other prayers, and we'd like to offer some dakshina, some offering to the very competent and capable teacher Sri Janak Rai Upadhyay.
Ayushtamate Swasti.
And to all the students.
साल की पहले की बात हो क्या हो
हाँ आपके 20 साल पहले पूज्यपाद प्रभुपाद महाराज जी का मूर्ति लेकर के द्वारिका में पद यात्रा में हरे राम हरे कृष्ण का पूरा मंडल द्वारिका में आए और यहाँ पर 5 दिन का प्राण प्रतिष्ठा का कार्यक्रम रखा गया था और सब प्राण प्रतिष्ठा के कार्यक्रम में हम और अपने वेद विद्यालय के छात्र वगैरह सब साथ में थे, द्वारका के पंडित लोग भी साथ में थे और आपके यहाँ से भी अच्छे अच्छे विद्वान वो भी साथ में थे और पूर्ण विधि से 5 दिन तक का प्राण प्रतिष्ठा का कार्यक्रम इसी द्वारकाधीश मंदिर के प्रांगण में माधव जी के मंदिर के चौक में किया गया जो सामने स्थित है।
अच्छा समाचार है कि अभी तक वो पदयात्रा चल रही है।
पदयात्रा चल रही है और आपके
4 बार पूरा भारत
परिक्रमा किया है और हम
द्वारकाधीश की
कृपा है और हम लोगों को भी ऐसा मौका मिला लंदन जाके उसी मूर्ति का फिर से दर्शन करने का और आपको भी फिर से सौभाग्य मिला कि 25 साल के पहले जो प्राण प्रतिष्ठा हुआ था उसी जगह आज आप लोग भी आए। आपका स्वागत है द्वारका जी में। भगवान सबका कल्याण करे द्वारिका जी,
आशीर्वाद दे जिससे हम बार बार
पूरे द्वारका वासियों का आशीर्वाद है कि आप हर साल आते रहिए द्वारका जी में।
इट्स टाइम फॉर चेंजिंग द फ्लैग। दिस फैमिली हैज हैड प्रिपेयर्ड अ न्यू फ्लैग व्हिच दे आर रिस्पेक्टफुली एंड ब्लिसफुली कैरिंग ऑन देयर हेड्स। आई गेट द चांस टू। How lucky to get the Lord's mercy in this way. That's something to dance for. Time to climb up 235 feet. Individuals or groups can sponsor the making of a new pennant. There's heavy demand and booking for sponsorship is usually about 3 months in advance. The flag is made according to specific designs that symbolize all the powers in the universe. The flag also represents everything that Dwaraka stands for. Namely devotion to Lord Krishna, Dwarkadhish. It always flies magnificently in a constant, strong sea wind and can be seen from everywhere in the town, reminding everyone of Krishna, Dwarkadhish. Traditionally, people would walk to Dwarka. Trains and buses are a relatively new invention. Over the plains, the first thing the pilgrims would see is the flag. After having journeyed for days or maybe even months, their excitement increases and increases in expectation of soon fulfilling the goal of their journey, darshan, or audience with the Lord. Gradually, they make out the spire, then the whole temple. Then after bathing for purification, they at last enter the temple, see the Lord, and feel their lives to be successful.
This beautiful flag is central to Dwaraka's culture. It symbolizes everything that Dwaraka stands for. Devotion to Lord Krishna. It always flies magnificently in the wind. There's always this strong sea wind coming in. So the flag can be seen all over the town. Reminds everyone of Dwarkadhish, Krishna. And even people coming from a long distance, traditionally people would walk to Dwarka. These trains and buses is a relatively new invention. And from over the plains, from a long distance, the first thing they see of Dwarka is the flag flying in the breeze. And then gradually they see the spire of the temple and their excitement having walked for days or even in some cases for months to be here. Their excitement increases and increases and increases until they finally come and have audience of the Lord. Let's ask one of the pujaris about this flag. Here's Sri Paresh Padia.
Yes.
He's a pujari here at the temple. Oh, and here's, come. Here's the fellow who's brought the new flag, which is flying now, and got back as prasad the old flag, which was flying, which we are fortunate to put on our head. Please tell us something about the flags. They're changed three times a day. Can you tell us about
yes,
that?
We have one tradition here.
Yeah.
So every day, three times change this flag.
Yeah, what time?
And 8 o'clock to 12:30, two time change. 8 o'clock to 11 o'clock,
yeah.
Number one flag.
Yeah.
11 o'clock to 12:30, second flag.
Yeah, so we just saw the second flag of the day being
just
torched.
Now is the second flag is already. And third flag is 5 o'clock to 6:30 o'clock is third flag.
That's the third change, sometime in the evening. And that will go all night then up until 8 o'clock in the morning.
All night is...
All right. So, aapka shubh naam kya hai?
Lalit
Bhai Javedi.
Trivedi.
Trivedi. And aap kaha ka hai? Kaha se hai?
Dwarka ji ka hi hai.
It's a local Brahmin.
He's a local Brahmin, yeah. Oh, acha. Aap wo sab change karte hai?
Change karte hai.
Oh, acha. Aap nahi laya bahar se?
Bahar se nahi laya. Aap chalane wala
hai. Acha, acha. So he is the gentleman who climbs up every time with no safety belt, nothing. Even sometimes the wind is extremely strong, but he goes up there and changes it. And by the grace of Lord Dwarkadhish, no problem.
No problem, without any tension.
So people are bringing in, mostly they bring in from different villages, is it? Or individuals, they sponsor it.
Yes,
it's 52 gaj, that's about 40 meters long. There's a specific design. So from the flag and from the cloth that is worn by Krishna, you can see this kind of shirt. It's called bandi, no?
Yes, bandi.
Bandi, that's made, and the pujaris and the different Brahmins in the town will wear. You're wearing green today because...
Yes.
Green is Wednesday, and that goes together with the day and the
Budvar. So today is Wednesday.
Yeah.
So all Brahminas, all worshippers, and all gods and goddesses use green dresses.
Yeah.
And Thursday, orange. Friday, white. Mm. Saturday, blue. Mm. Sunday, red. Monday, pink. And Tuesday yellow. Mm-hmm. So we have used day by day colors.
Yeah.
Every day change.
And so different colors express different emotions and moods.
Yes. It's from Shastra colors.
Right.
By Shastra.
According to Shastra.
Shastra colors.
In Uddhav, in the time of Krishna Leela, he is the most famous devotee in Dwaraka.
Yeah.
Uddhavji Maharaj.
Uddhavji Maharaj. Yes.
There's one very nice verse from Bhagavatam. He says to Krishna, Svayopabhukta Sraggandha Vasalankara Charchitaha Uchishta Bhojano Dasas Tavamaya Jayemahi. That by taking the food offered to you, my dear Krishna, that by taking the food which is enjoyed by you, the clothing, the flower garland, the scent, by using all the things already used by you, we easily conquer over your Maya. So simply by wearing this, you can be free from Maya. No need to go to the Himalayas and do austerity. You wear this, be a devotee of Krishna, and Krishna will look after you.
Now it's time to bring Lord Dwarkadhish his midday meal. It's called Chapan Bhog, meaning 56 items. Every day at this time, 56 preparations, opulent and fit for the King of Kings, are offered to Dwarkadhish. Here is the head priest announcing that the Lord's food is coming and everyone should get out of the way. It's all prepared in a kitchen reserved only for cooking for the deity. And of course, only from pure vegetarian ingredients. The offering is covered so that it is not seen by the public before presenting it to the Lord.
This is the man, head pujari, head worshipper in Lord Krishna temple.
Dwarkadhish
temple.
I'm very fortunate.
Mr. Upen Bhai Thakur.
All the Thakurs, they're the...
All our Thakurs, 20 families do the puja after
Lord Krishna.
80 families.
20
families.
20 families.
Yes.
And this is?
This is the symbol of Chadi.
The royal insignia.
Symbol. There is a kingdom of Lord Krishna. Dwarka is a kingdom. And when king coming, there is one man spoken, there is a king are coming.
And he's holding
it. It is a symbol of king coming.
Okay, yeah. Like, he had a blessing.
Yeah, blessing you. So, there is a peaceful life in Dwarka. I do not go anywhere.
You are in Dwarka, the king is Krishna.
Krishna.
So how do you feel about being his citizen?
That is happiness and very satisfied life here. I not go anywhere, in India or in abroad.
You don't want to go to America?
I don't go anywhere. Ayodhya, Mathura, Maya, Kasi, Kanchi, Vantika, Puri, Dwara, Vatishtaigo, Sappaite, Moksha Jayaka.
Moksha Jayaka means when you die here in Dwarka, you go to Krishna.
Go to Krishna.
No more born
no
again.
No more birth. No more
finished.
Bones. Finished. God blessing you, and you come again at Dwarka on as early as possible. Okay.
That's a good blessing.
Ah, God blessing you, and you come again as early as possible at Dwarka.
What does Dwarka mean, actually?
There is the road Krishna coming from Martha.
Ah.
There is a port, and all the men are asked, where is door? Dwarka.
Ah.
His name Dwarka.
It's very short name of Dwarka. Actually, full name is Dwarkaha. Dwarkaha is asking.
Where is the door?
Asking for pilgrims. Dwarkaha. So its short name is Dwarka.
Dwarka.
Hare Krishna. Bhakta Nugrakataroti Karunam. Lavanya Pathodadi. Savyo Brahma Sivendra Yogi Vivudai. Raja Dirajo Hari. Mathura Chorke Bhagwan Jab Dwarka Meaye. तब यहां भगवान ने इस सुंदर नगरी का निर्माण
He is a colorful fellow eager to share his take on life and goings on in Dwarka.
वैसे भगवान का जो यह नगरी थी यह शिखरबंद नहीं था
Here's another of the several shrines within the temple complex. The back entrance is called the Moksha Dwara. The gate of liberation from material existence. The idea is that by passing through, one enters the presence of the Lord, who takes us to his abode. Honoring sacred water. Time to go. I have a lunch invitation with a local Brahmana family. Their house is somewhere around here. Notwithstanding the spiritual ambience, some parts of Dwarka today are physically a little run down. A heartwarming traditional welcome.
Let's meet the oldest man in Dwarka. He's the head of four generations of the Taka clan. His name is Purushottam Haridas Thakur. He's 95 years old.
Jai Dwarkadhish Ji.
Jai Dwarkadhish Ji. आपको देख के बहुत आनंद होता है।
Good good.
मुझे भी बहुत आनंद। द्वारकाधीश की कृपा।
हमको बहुत आनंद हुआ। आपको देख के।
हरे कृष्ण।
भगवान।
मैं इनका ग्रेट ग्रैंडसन हूँ। आप जो भी प्रश्न पूछना चाहते हैं वो आप हमको पूछ सकते हैं। जो भी इस प्रकार की
ठीक है। मैं आपको हेल्प करूँ। पुराने जमाने में और आधुनिक काल में बहुत बड़ा फर्क पड़ता है ना तो आप बताइए आपका
दादा पहला जमाना में अटाणा जमाना में कितना फर्क है द्वारका में के जे
बहुत फर्क हो गया एक ऐसा बहुत फर्क हो गया
जैसे
कई रीते फर्क हूँ फिर सो पड़ो ई गयो
पहले तो आदमी आते थे दो तीन दिन खेलते थे अभी तो आया और दर्शन करके चला गया
और पैदल से आते थे नहीं या बैलगाड़ी से
ट्रेन में आते थे
ट्रेन में बस में
ट्रेन में
कोई
पैदल चल के आते थे
अभी तक कुछ लोग पैदल से आते हैं कम लोग
आते हैं पहले जैसे नहीं आते हैं
और क्या लोग का स्वभाव में क्या फर्क है
आस्था और श्रद्धा थी तो नहीं अभी तो आया और ये दर्शन क्या नहीं चल गया पहले तो दो तीन चार दिन खेलते
और आपका पिताश्री बहुत बड़े भगत थे नहीं
हमारे पिताश्री मंदिर में भजन करते थे पहले
सुनो वो हर रात को भगवान का शयन का समय वो नाचते थे भगवान के सामने कीर्तन करके
कीर्तन करते
हरिदास जी आपके पिताजी
भगवान के सामने
और ब्रिटिश के जमाने में कैसे था
अंग्रेजों के जमाने में द्वारका में क्या परिस्थिति थी
अंग्रेजों के जमाने में छोड़ के चला गया कुछ ऐसा फेर नहीं था अभी ऐसे ज्यादा फेर नहीं था
ज्यादा फर्क नहीं था अंग्रेजों के जमाने में यहाँ इतना कम था जैसे भारत के और जगह पर में था इतना ज्यादा दबाव
ब्रिटिश का प्रभाव ज्यादा नहीं था
प्रभाव यहाँ नहीं था ज्यादा यहाँ कम था द्वारका के अंदर
गायकवाड़ सरकार का ये मानी का राजा
वो सब गायकवाड़ का राज्य में था
के राज्य में था तो वो हिसाब से यहाँ पर में ज्यादा कोई फर्क नहीं था जैसे अभी है वैसे ही था
चार धाम में बड़ा धाम सात पुरी में मुख्य पुरी रामेश्वर जगन्नाथ बद्रीनाथ और द्वारकानाथ चार बड़ा धाम सात पुरी पुरी अयोध्या मथुरा माया काशी कांची अवंती का और सप्त में मोक्ष विभाग का द्वारका देश नाम सुन के चोरी से राजा याद ही अब तो तू ही अब तो तू ही बचा ले मुझको बाप करे मोरी तू ही रामा तू ही कृष्णा तू ही नंदकिशोर जी
जय द्वारकाधीश
जय द्वारकाधीश जय द्वारकाधीश
Now it's time for a traditional Gujarati meal. This is not ordinary food. It's called prasad, mercy, and is sanctified by being offered to Lord Krishna. I learned many things here. This family claims descent from Brahmanas who Lord Krishna brought to Dwaraka 5,000 years ago. They told me that up to about 50 years ago at the time of Arati, people would leave their shops, homes open to go and attend. The streets would be empty because everyone would be in the temple. People were so honest that no one had locks on their door. Everyone in Dwaraka has firm devotion to Dwarkadhish and feels fully protected by him. Dwaraka faces the coast of Pakistan, and during the 1965 war, the Pakistan Navy bombarded undefended Dwaraka, but although they had a clear shot, all their missiles went over the town and none exploded. More recently, there was a major cyclone and then the earthquake of 2001. In both cases, for 200 kilometers around, everything was devastated, but Dwaraka remained.